once you get established with the puddle control being consistent, now we can go ahead and introduce some filler metal. At this point, we've already practiced our hand control with the torch, our motion, torch angles, and now we're going to add introducing the filler metal. We try to tell people to start introducing the filler metal with a dab and move motion. Dab it, move the torch. Dab it, move the torch. Dab it, move the torch. And just pick up that rhythm. There's no need for excessive torch movements. It's not like oxy-fuel welding where you're constantly moving the torch in the heat zone. This area here maintains a steady motion. This hand is doing most of the movement. First, we're going to establish our puddle, increasing our current control until the puddle is established. We're going to start adding filler metal to the edge of the puddle. We're going to start moving, dab, move, dab the filler, move, dab the filler. And as you master that move and dab technique, you can start picking up your rhythm. And pretty soon you'll be just moving and dabbing in one motion. So here we see we've made our first pass with adding the filler metal. We're maintaining a proper, consistent width of the bead. So in other words, we've got our puddle control down pat. Our puddle deposition is pretty consistent, so we were adding the filler metal consistently. And our travel speed wasn't too excessive. There are a number of things that come into play when controlling the puddle on aluminum.